Hi students, welcome to Sakshi FIT NEET Academy. In this video session, we are going to learn about one of the important preparation methods of orthohydroxybenzaldehyde. Orthohydroxybenzaldehyde, also known as salicylaldehyde, So here, to get a salicylaldehyde, we are taking a phenol. So to this phenol, we are giving a concentrated chloroform. Presence of base. As well, finally we are taking a acid, then we will get a orthohydroxybenzaldehyde. So this reaction also known as Reimer-Tiemann reaction. This Reimer-Tiemann reaction we will observe in a one of the chemical properties of phenol. In a alcohols, phenols, ether chapter. So here, what is Reimer-Tiemann reaction path and it's a mechanism? So we will discuss on the board. So let's begin. Reimer-Tiemann reaction. So first here I am taking a reaction path, that is here phenol, that is hydroxy substituted benzene called phenol. This phenol is treating with a concentrated chloroform, that is CHCl3 chloroform. Presence of base, here I am taking NaOH, you can take any strong base. Here I am taking NaOH, so finally we are taking a HCl, that is a acid. Then we will get a orthohydroxybenzaldehyde. This is also known as salicylaldehyde. So this is the reaction path. Phenol, which we are treating with a concentrated chloroform, presence of base. We will get a final intermediate. So when we are taking a acid workup with that final intermediate, then we will get a salicylaldehyde, that is orthohydroxybenzaldehyde. Here I am taking a mechanism. First, we need to prepare a, that is carbene intermediate from this chloroform, treating with the base, So here I am taking a chloroform, that is CHCl3 with a NaOH, We know this is a strong base, converts into Na plus OH minus. This OH minus abstracting this H plus from the chloroform, see here, how this H plus is generating this carbon to hydrogen bond cleaving heterolytically, and this carbon gaining electrons, These bond electrons are shifted to the carbon. So as soon as this bond electron shifted to the carbon, this carbon to chlorine bond get cleave heterolytically, and this chlorine coming out as a Cl minus, Na plus minus NaCl, OH minus H plus minus H2O. So both the fragments, positive fragment, negative fragment, are eliminating from the same carbon, also known as alpha elimination. So what we are getting here, this carbon with a two bond pairs with a two electrons. So these two electrons came from this bond, that is called a carbene, Now here, this is the carbene intermediate. Already we have another video about a carbene reactive intermediate. So what is singlet carbene, what is a triplet carbene? So commonly, based on this electron arrangement and their spin states, we have classified this carbene into singlet and triplet. So what is singlet? When this carbon having a two bonds with the two electrons, both the electrons are present in a one orbital and another orbital is empty. This is called a singlet. So what about triplet? Here, bivalent carbon which having a two unpairs, that means both the electrons are present in a separate orbital, as a unpairs. This is called a triplet. So now here, this is a carbene intermediate which here we are taking as a singlet, and here other orbital is empty orbital. This is acts as a electrophile. a neutral electrophile presence of a empty orbital, presence of empty orbital. Commonly, carbene acts as a electrophile. Carbene acts as a neutral electrophile. Now we are taking this electrophile with the phenol. So obviously, phenol involving in a electrophilic substitution with that carbene, with the carbene. So we know that benzene involves in a substitution, not in a addition, because of that pi bond electrons revolves in a cyclic system, that is also known as a resonance. So due to the resonance, the pi bonds which are present in the benzene ring do not participate in a addition reaction. This participates in a substitution reaction. So here first actually this phenol treat with the base, we will get a sodium phenoxide. See here, Na plus, OH minus. What about the phenol is acidic in nature, generates a H plus on bond cleavage between oxygen to hydrogen. See here, these bond electrons are shifted to oxygen, H plus coming to the OH minus, minus H2O. Here we are getting a O minus Na plus, O minus Na plus. This is called sodium phenoxide, sodium phenoxide. So what about this sodium phenoxide? So I'm taking here that sodium phenoxide now involving in a electrophilic substitution reaction. So O minus, this bond electron shifting here. Now see, these pi electrons are, see here, this is negative charge and having a empty shell. See here, these electrons are coming here. This is not a negative charge. You can take a like a electrons are present in a one orbital. See, these pi electrons are filling this empty orbital. Then we are getting a intermediate which there is a new bond between this carbon to this carbon with a Cl, and here electrons are there. So now to stabilize this, see here, this carbon to hydrogen bond get cleaving, and these pi electrons, this sigma bond electrons are converting into pi electrons, and these pi electrons are shifted towards this oxygen. Then we are getting, see, when this carbon to hydrogen bond electrons are shifted here, what about this hydrogen? Hydrogen coming as a H plus. This H plus is abstracted by this lone pair. Then CHCl2, and this electron shifted here, this pi electron shifted to oxygen. We are getting as it is, bond here, bond here, bond here, O minus Na plus, and here we have the bond between carbon to carbon and hydrogen, and hydrogen. Now see here, this intermediate is going to take up base. We are giving a one more mole of base, Na plus OH minus. So here you can understand this simply a nucleophilic substitution reactions. Here this negative fragment which is OH minus is substituting a here the place of Cl minus, in the place of Cl minus, Cl minus coming outside, OH minus substituting here. Then minus NaCl, minus NaCl, this O minus Na plus as it is, bond here, bond here, bond here. See, instead of one chlorine, here we have a OH. Out of two, we have one chlorine and here hydrogen. Again, we are taking a one more mole of base, Na, OH, Na plus, OH minus. Again, one more time, nucleophilic substitution reaction. OH minus coming to here and attacking this carbon, and Cl minus going outside. Cl minus Na plus minus NaCl. Here we are getting a sodium phenoxide with the carbon which having a two hydroxy groups, carbon which having a two hydroxy groups undergoes dehydration, undergoes dehydration. Simply see here, oxygen to hydrogen bond electrons are converting into pi bond, and H plus is coming outside, H plus OH minus. See, oxygen to hydrogen bond electrons are shifting here as a pi bond, and carbon to oxygen bond getting cleaved because OH acts as a best leaving group. Best leaving group, when we have a, this is alpha hydrogen coming as a H plus, and that oxygen to hydrogen bond electrons are converting into pi bond, and your carbon to oxygen bond get cleaving hydrolytically. That's what O minus with hydrogen OH minus H plus minus H2O. We got finally aldehyde functional group here, and here O minus Na plus, O minus Na plus. So to this we are giving a acid. To this we are giving a acid. It's H plus Cl minus. H plus is migrating O minus towards O minus Na plus Cl minus minus NaCl. So finally we are getting salicylaldehyde. Finally we are getting salicylaldehyde. So this is the mechanism behind a Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Riemer-Thiemann reaction, simply first preparation of carbene which acts as a electrophile. So here phenol with a electrophile, we can say it's a electrophilic substitution reaction. So in electrophilic substitution reaction, this carbene empty shell is filled by these pi electrons, then the bond is need to retain, so that we going to retain by giving carbon to hydrogen sigma bond electrons, and this pi electron shifting a O minus. See here O minus Na plus, and this carbon which is converted into neutral with a 2 Cl, two chlorine groups. These two chlorine groups are this compound again taking with a base Na plus OH minus. Here nucleophilic substitution, O minus attacking here, Cl minus coming outside, minus NaCl. We are getting this next step again, one more time nucleophilic substitution, OH minus coming here, Cl minus coming outside, minus NaCl. Then we are getting the carbon with a two hydroxy groups undergoes dehydration, because one is a both OH groups acts as a leaving group. So out of two, one is giving H plus, one is completely going as a OH minus, minus H2O. Then we are getting a aldehyde group with this phenoxide, with this sodium phenoxide. So to relieve this, to convert this into phenol, we are taking a acid, taking a acid. Then H plus is neutralizing O minus Na plus Cl minus, minus NaCl. Finally we are getting salicylaldehyde. Finally we are getting salicylaldehyde. So this is a Riemer-Thiemann reaction, one of the chemical properties of phenol, one of the chemical properties of phenol. So hope you understand well. If you like the video, subscribe the channel, share, like, comment, and hit the bell icon so that you will get latest video lectures. Thank you.